Throughout this season of Green Fingers, we've been showing you these amazing systems, and they really are very easy to set up. A hydroponics tray, expanded clay, a pump, a tank, and within a few short days, you're growing your own range of edible plants and a fantastic selection of fish. The other great thing is, they're easy to manage. So Maurice, we're going to be using the expanded clay to plant into. It really is our best option, isn't it?
Yes, Steve, it is, absolutely. We've looked at other options, but the expanded clay has the greatest capillary properties. It's lightweight, very long-lasting. And we've looked at river stone and pea gravel and regular granite stone, and even though they're cheaper options sort of thing, they don't stack up for those capillary properties, getting the microbial action, and also they're about 2 to 3 times heavier than the expanded clay.
This looks like the way to go.
Absolutely, it's a great product.
It's most important that we let the water settle for 24 hours, Maurice.
Yeah, that's very important, Steve. It allows the chlorine to dissipate out the water, and it allows the fish to be healthy and satisfied in that water.
Well, in this particular pond we're putting in rainbow trout, one of my favourite. What sort of cost are we looking at with our fish?
Well, fingerlings started at roughly $1 a centimetre, so they start from a couple of bucks each. But rainbow trout at this time of year are the most freely available fish for us through the nursery stocks. We'll cope with a temperature of about 16 to 18 degrees, while the Barramundi are about 26 to 28 degrees, so they're kind of 10 degrees cooler fish.
Fantastic. Now, the kids are on a great project here. They've started to plant. They're putting in silver beet, lettuce, strawberries, chives. How's it going there, kids?
Great!
Fantastic. One of the other options, Maurice, is to use these add-on grow channels. Tell us a little bit about these.
Yeah, I believe you saw those down at Murdoch TAFE.
We did.
These are an 80 by 70 mil hydro channel. They're UV stabilised and they're absolutely perfect for growing lettuce. Check the roots out on that one there, Steve.
Amazing, mate. Absolutely beautiful.
Quite simply, just add that to as part of the plumbing off to the side of your channel, of your tray. That's no problem.
So, great way to extend the system. Fish hides. These look simple and easy to build. Tell us a little bit about those.
Yeah, they're a great DIY thing, Steve. The trout and the yabbies, they love hiding away in there. Keeps them nice and dark and secure.
We've got all our test kits here to make sure the water stays nice and healthy. But I think a really important part of a lot of these systems, Maurice, are the metal frames to go over, just to protect young children from any problems.
Yeah, it's a big safety issue for schools. Obviously, a body of water needs to be covered so that safe for the kids.
Nice, simple, easy way to do it. Black plastic cover over the top. Now, this really helps keeping the algae levels to a bare minimum, and you'd recommend that we put this in place?
Yeah, it's good if you've got a tank that's covered, because you stop the full sun getting into the tank growing a lot of algae, and that, of course, draws down on what the plants can't take up as nitrogen. So we're trying to reduce down the algae biomass.
OK, so it's just a great way to keep the system lovely and healthy.
Absolutely, yep.
Brilliant. All right, well, it just keeps getting better all the time here. Fantastic system, great way to grow our own fish, grow our own fresh, healthy veggies. Thanks, Maurice.
You're welcome, Steve. Thank you.